What if you were raised in a loving family and still have food addictions? To answer this question, we have to talk about how the food addiction is developed. The first feeling of love we receive through breastfeeding. The baby's brain is not developed yet. All his receptors are concentrated in the mouth. He feels pleasure through the mouth. The breast milk is fatty and sweet, and we like food that is fatty and sweet. On the cellular level, when we want to feel love and experience pleasure, we are drawn to fatty and sweet food, completely unconsciously. This is the first reason why people who were raised in a loving family can still develop a food addiction. Because when we eat fatty and sweet food, we experience pleasure feelings inside of our mouth. When a baby is crying, the first thing that most mothers do is they feed the baby. If the baby does not eat, then the mother will think about other reasons why he is crying. The baby might cry because his pampers need to be changed, because his teeth are growing, because he was scared by a sudden noise, or because he was tired of lying down on his right side. But the common reaction of most mothers will be to feed the baby first. So the child is learning, no matter what is happening to me, the first thing I have to do is eat. And then I can deal with the situation. If I feel pain, I have to eat. If I feel discomfort, I have to eat. If I'm afraid, I have to eat. This is the second reason why people with a happy childhood might develop eating addiction. When we feel depressed, we want to eat sweet to feel happy. When we are stressed out, we want to eat to get energy. When we are angry or terrified of something, we want to eat to calm down. All our emotions are related to food. On the next webinar, I will talk in detail about food and emotions. People are addicted to different things. Some people are addicted to chocolate and sweets. Others are addicted to chips. Some are addicted to nuts. Although nuts are considered to be as a healthy snack, those people can eat lots of them and receive more calories than they need. On the next webinar, I will teach you about specific emotions and what types of food we use to substitute those feelings. We will talk about anger, loneliness, sadness, boredom, hidden aggression, and anxiety. If you want to watch that webinar about food and emotions, the link is below the video. By the time you watch this video, the other webinar should be already recorded and uploaded to YouTube.